So when people normally think about robots, usually they're picturing something like the Terminator or C-3PO from Star Wars. But recently, in the last 10 years or so, there's been this new development of a different class of robots, and these are called soft robots. These soft robots use fluids like air or water, and they have soft, flexible materials. So there is a lot of interest in soft robotics, mainly because they offer benefits over traditional hard robotics, like safety for human-robot interactions. With inflatable soft robotics, they can kind of reform to be able to grasp things like delicate objects or with complex geometries that change. They're able to do that in a way that would be very difficult to do using conventional hard robotics. One of the major challenges that has kind of come about with this emergence of soft robotics is that it's become more and more difficult to control the various, what are called actuators, these different limbs. We've built on our history developing 3D printed microfluidic circuitry to create an entirely new class of integrated fluidic circuits, and we've integrated them directly inside of our soft robots. And we've printed them completely assembled in a single print run. We're using a completely different type of 3D printing technology, and it's called PolyJet 3D printing. And the way that it works is very similar to a color printer, but instead of just printing a single page down, what we're doing is we're printing a page after a page after a page. And what's special about it is, just like a color printer where you can print different types of colors, here what we're doing is we can print hard materials, we can print soft, flexible materials, and we can print what are called support materials that help it to hold up during the printing process, and then we can dissolve with water afterwards.
Soft robotics is often inspired by biology. In our case, we were inspired by a turtle. It's our mascot at UMD. We were using the soft limbs to be the actuators for our robot, demonstrating that we can inflate and deflate these arms to move back and forth given simple constant flow inputs.
So normally, if you wanted to be able to play Nintendo with a soft robotic hand, you would need a separate control line connected to every one of these fingers. And the more fingers you have, the more control lines you would need, which limits portability and limits usability of that type of approach. We designed special types of fluidic transistors. And so these fluidic transistors have certain properties. So if there's no pressure, nothing gets pressed. If there's a low pressure, then this first finger begins to actuate, and it'll press this button for Mario to begin moving forward. If you go to a medium pressure, this finger here will begin pressing the controller buttons, causing Mario to begin running. And then finally, if you go to a high pressure, all three fingers will press down on their respective buttons on the controller to make Mario run and jump. We actually originally wrote a program that is controlled using a computer. We press start on the computer and we walk away, and the hand is able to autonomously press the different buttons based on that computer program. Being able to rapidly disseminate these types of designs with integrated circuitry, and to be able to rapidly modify them and share those advances freely and openly, and with this single print run process for being able to print these entire soft robotic systems, our hope is that by doing so, we'll be able to increase the access to these types of soft robotic technologies, and hopefully the adoption, and in turn, be able to accelerate advancement in this new field of soft robotics.
Fourth! Oh, that's too bad.